and now we will learn how to record deposits with cash back for expenses. What exactly happened that caused you to use the deposit window instead of making a sale receipt? Well, you received cash from a customer for a service. You did not immediately deposit the cash into the bank. Instead, you used some of the cash for expenses or for non-business reasons. For example, let's imagine on February 22, we received $900 cash for 3 video hours for Betty. $100 of the $900 was used to purchase supplies, probably from Staples. $200 of the $900 was used to pay UPS for a delivery, and the remaining $600 was deposited. So, what's going on here? Well, you must use the deposit window despite its limitations because you didn't deposit the cash. You spent from cash that the customer handed you. And let's imagine the deposit number is 616161 because there's always some kind of confirmation number or transaction number. In this case, it'll be the deposit number. So how do we record this? Well, it's very simple. In the top right, we click the plus sign, and then we click Bank Deposit. Okay, the date of the deposit was February 22. Now, it already knows the bank account that we deposited from. Under Receive From, we're going to choose the customer Betty, because that's where you put the name. Now, of course, this is asking us for something that we will learn in a future video, double checking a human error that you could make on something we're going to learn soon. Let's close it out. The account is video income because we earned video income from Betty. Now, go all the way to the right in the amount field. In the amount field, you have to put the total that you actually received from, the total you actually received from the customer. Pushing the tab key on the left of your keyboard will move the cursor to the next line. So the video income that we earned is $900. Now I agree with you, the amount of the deposit was only $600. That's because we're not finished. But you still have to acknowledge the total income that you earned on the first line. On the second line, we record the fact that we paid Staples for supplies $100. Okay? Notice it made it bigger. You know why? Very important. When you record cash back, you have to put the minus sign next to the amount of the money that you spent for the expense with cash back. Then push the tab key on the left of your keyboard. Notice it decreased the total deposit. You should do it for the next cash expenditure to UPS. UPS you spent for delivery expense, which is down here, delivery expense. And the amount you paid for delivery was $200. Okay, well, excuse me, that's in the wrong field. Okay, the amount you paid was $200, but you should put minus $200 and then push tab. Notice the deposit goes down to the amount that was actually physically deposited. So this is going to go into video income for the full $900 that you earned. This is going to go into supplies for the amount that you paid for supplies, and it will increase supplies. This $200 is going to go for delivery expense, and it will increase the amount that you paid for delivery, even though it's decreasing your bank account. And this would be the way to record it. As far as the check, the deposit number 6161, I recommend you put it in the top line for the reference number. I guess it really doesn't matter as long as it's somewhere, but it's probably a good idea to put it in the reference number of the top line. Now when we click Save and Close, we know that things are recorded appropriately, and now Let's check the accounts to say if to see if they increased correctly. Well, if we go to reports and we open up my trial balance, first let's see if the 600, not 900, was recorded in cash in Chase Bank. I open up the Chase Bank account by clicking on it, and look, the very latest transaction, February 22nd, only 600. Because it says it's split between several accounts. So we know that's correct. Let's go back to the summary, which is the trial balance. Now let's open up supplies. Okay, double click. And you can see the last purchase of supplies was February 22nd for $100. It came from a deposit. And notice it increased the amount you spent on supplies by $100. We'll check one last one. That's right. The last one to check is delivery expense. Double click on the number and you can see the last delivery expense for $200 that increased the amount that you paid for delivery by $200 was done by this deposit on February 22nd.